श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम। स्वागतम। टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस व्हाट प्रत्याहार आर एंड वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग देम ऑल अलोंग। हाउ डू वी मेक सम प्रत्याहारास फॉर आवर सेल्व्स। दिस इज अ मेक योर सेल्फ डू इट योर सेल्फ रेसिपी फॉर प्रत्याहारास। नाउ दिस विल बी अ शॉर्ट वीडियो because the next topic would be the fourth arrangement called the prayatnaha. That will be in the next video. But in this, we shall quickly wind up with the Maheshwara Sutra. Now we have been discussing pratyaharas. What are these pratyaharas? We have already explained them. What are they? Those are acronyms that we use to retrieve a set of letters that we want to use. So you can refer them in the previous videos of Maheshwara Sutras. For now, after having defined them briefly, we shall see how to make some pratyaharas for ourselves. So let's go through the rules, the algorithm for making pratyaharas. Pratyaharas are acronyms again. Write down the first letter of the set. Now, let's say I have a set of letters that I want to name. Let's say, A O I O Hayavara. Okay. A I O O Hayavara. And these letters should conform with the order of Maheshwara Sutra. That is how they occur in the Maheshwara Sutra. You can't just pick some random letters like A, Kha, Ka, and Ya. It won't work then. You have to first of all refer to the table. And from here you have to see which letters you want. I will say for now, as an example, A, O, I, O, Haya, Vara. I want only these letters. Now tell me, how do I retrieve it? It's very simple. Find the first letter of that set, which is A. Then find the last dead consonant. Now, which is the last letter in our set? We want R. So which is the dead consonant immediately after it, which is T. Then the acronym will be 8. It will be 8. He ate it. Yeah, of course. A and T, 8. Now let's do one more. Now that is what is given here in the algorithm. So write down the first letter of the set, and this order should be according to the Maheshwara Sutras. So you have to refer it from the table itself. So write down the first letter, which is X. So what is the last letter in our set? It is Y. Then find its position in the Maheshwara Sutras. See which is the dead consonant immediately following it. Call it Z. So then acronym will be the X plus Z, which is XZ. Here in the example, I've demonstrated A, E, U, R, L. Now which is X here? Now this is the sutra, this is the set. As it occurs in the order of the Maheshwara Sutra. See, it occurs I, U, and R, L, right? I want only these five. Then you have to choose the first letter, which is X is A, the last letter is L, and go to the sutras, which is S2, which is the sutra 2, and find the letter which is immediately after L. What is that? K. So the acronym will be AK. Done. AK. Simple. Let's play around a little more. Let's say I want to find an acronym for Ba ga da da kha pha cha tha tha cha ta ta ka pa. What will it be? Find the first letter B, find the last letter P, find the dead halanta just after it, ya. Combine the two, it will become Bai. Bai. That will be the pratyahara. Bai. You can name this pratyahara Bai and say that you have invented this pratyahara Bai. And then what will be I want to include in the set? Ka pa sha sha sa. What will that be? It will be ka pa sha sha sa. So the sutra is 12, first one, find the first letter ka. Then which is the last letter sa? Find a dead halanta after it ra. So it will be kar. Kar is ka pa sha sha sa. It need not just always start with the first letter itself. I can choose, for example, Bhash. What will it be? So the first letter is Bha, the last halanta is Sha. So everything is included within Bha and Sha. Of course, excluding the dead halantas because they are dead. Bha, Gha, Dha, Dha. Correct. Bha, Gha, Dha, Dha. Of course, you have to again not consider the Sha itself in the set because it is the dead halanta. Then let's do one more example and then we'll move on. Let's say you want Khar. What is Khar? Khar. So first letter Kha, last dead halanta is Ra. So everything within that, excluding the dead halanta. So Kha, Pha, Cha, Tha, Tha, Cha, Ta, Ta, Ka, Pa, Sha, Sha, Sa. Simple. Remove the Va, Ya, Ra, etc. because they're dead. Throw them away and then you have the set that you want. So you are retrieved with the set. Now this is the second part of it. Finally, what I wanted to mention here is that you always have to end the acronym with a dead halanta, which means, as was discussed in the previous video, you can't say how, hava. You can't say hava to include only ha, ya, va. That is not possible. It should be in this order, which means to include ha, ya, va in one sutra, in one acronym, in one pratyahara was impossible, is impossible. You can't say hayava, hayava, or you can't say hava to only include these three. That is wrong. Which means by its impossibility, it also means, it suggests that hayava actually have nothing in common at all, which is shared by all three equally. Which also means that the set hayava is never going to be used ever in the Panini's Ashtadhyayi rule book. That means no rule governs, operates on Hayava simultaneously in the same rule. So that is a very powerful tool, in fact, a very powerful suggestion and observation that Panini has made. So by making the rule that you can't end with anything else but the dead halanta, he has also negated circumstances and instances where people would make create their own acronyms which had literally nothing at all in common, equally shared amongst themselves. So in fact, yan here, that what does that mean? It means yavara la has something in common which is explicitly stated by a rule in the Ashtadhyayi. So these texts alternate within each other. So from the Maheshwara Sutrani, you have to go to the rule book, and similarly back from the rule book to the Maheshwara Sutras. So this Yan actually is a set which is useful for a sandhi called the Yan Sandhi, which is governed by the Swara Sandhis. What it is, again, later. For now, we have to just understand that Pratyahara, which should necessarily end with a halanta, like these 14 halantas itself, actually suggests that, but you can start anywhere. You can start with anything. You can say out, you get out, out. You can say ait, you can say yet, you can say, but you can't go backwards. You can't say nut, that is not allowed. You have to always proceed forward. That is how our philosophy in life should also be. Always move forward. So you can say vam, but you can't say nut. Got it? Yes. And the finally, another observation that I want to make is here that you can see na occurs twice. The dead consonant na comes twice. So what does un mean? So does it mean a e u or does it mean a e u e o y o h v r l? What does it mean? Which of those two is correct? Actually, both of them are correct according to the algorithm stated. So which should be used? That depends on the commentator or Patanjali and or any other commentator like Bhattoji Deshta, etc. Whatever they interpret un as being is what we have to consider for that specific context. That is one thing I wanted to mention. And then So why is we have discussed one category of varnas called the ayoga vaha. What does that mean? Ayoga vaha, it actually means na yogam vahati iti. That which is not used, yoga means here used, that vahata which carries any use, which holds any usage in the what is that? Maheshwara Sutrani is called the ayoga vaha. So what are they now? That's a very good observation, in fact, again, that there is no visarga at all here. There is no anuswara. There is no af. There is no akh. None of those jihvamuliya, upadhmaniya, visarga or anuswara is present. That itself is the cause for getting their name ayoga vaha, because Panini didn't want them to be included in the Maheshwara Sutrani, because these four VIPs wanted special attention. They were lusting for attention. They hog people's attention and Panini's attention as well. Therefore, they were dealt with separately, hands-on by Panini in his rule book itself. They are not given any position because they didn't like any position in the Maheshwara Sutras, because they were very unique. They were unique in the sense that they didn't have a unique pronunciation, and everyone else had a unique pronunciation, but these four didn't have a unique pronunciation, for which they were expelled from the Maheshwara Sutras. And finally, the L, there is no Dirgha. When we were discussing where the Dirgha Swaras went, we said A, E, U, R had the Dirghas, which are to be understood as being symbolized by A, E, U, R itself. See here? These. But L does not have a Dirgha Swara. Why is that? I myself don't know the reason for that. But strangely, we have a Plutaswara for the L. It is not so. The reason here is not that L can't be elongated as a two-syllable word. The exact reason, I'm not sure. But strangely enough, we have a Plutaswara, which means the three-syllable elongation of the vowel is L is present, but the Dirgha form is missing. It is not explained in any book that I have come across till now. So if any one of you know, you can leave it down in the comments. So anyway, that's not a concern, because L itself in the Hrastva form itself was very rare, and Plutato is double rare, and the Dirgha being, whether it exists or not, is of no concern to us, because there is no word using either L or the Dirgha form. So it is not so much of a concern for us. In the next session, we shall discuss what the Prayatnas, the fourth system of classification. Now we have come so far with three, one being Balhana, second Utpatti, and the third Maheshwara. The fourth one shall be the Prayatna system, which we shall discuss later. For now, let's wind up with the Maheshwara Sutras. I hope all of you have understood a little bit, at least a glimpse into the intellectual capacity of Panini. धन्यवादः.